Hey viewers, how are you? Wish you happy and safe Holi to all of you and your family. So today, I share you most delicious and yummy Sahi Kesar Rasmalai recipe, which is one of the tradition and festive recipes of Bengal. It's mainly soft and spongy Rasgullas, which dipped in Sahi flavourful malai. Here, I show you all these things with each step by step process. Let's start this recipe. So, I take 1/2 liter full fated milk and heat it up to boil. When a layer of cream is formed over the full fated milk, then I add 2 pinches of saffron, 1/3 teaspoon of cardamom powder, and mix it well. After mixing these ingredients, I added 1/4 cup or 60 milliliters of condensed milk. Further, I add 2 tablespoons or 30 grams of sugar. Here, I add a few dry fruit like crushed cashew nut 2 tablespoons or 30 grams, pistachio 2 teaspoons or 10 grams, almond 1 tablespoon or 15 grams. And give a good mix. Now, I add 1 pinch of yellow food color and mixed it well. At last, I add 2 tablespoon or 30 gram of sugar and give a good mix. After a few minutes, I keep it into a bowl. For more shahi flavor, I added 1/4 teaspoon of rose water or gulab jal with it. Now, I prepare Rasgulla part of this rasmalai. So, I take fresh toned milk, 1.5 liter, and boil it for a few minutes. When it comes to a boil, turn off the flame and stirring it a few minutes, or leave it for few minutes for cooling to bring the temperature of this milk down a bit. For milk curdles, I take 2 tablespoons or 30 milliliters of vinegar and add 4 tablespoons or 120 milliliters of water with it. But you can also use lemon juice or milk curdles powder instead of vinegar. Now, I gradually added whole vinegar water mixture with this milk and continuously stirring it. Always don't curdle the milk as soon as it comes to a boil. Just wait for 5 to 10 minutes till the milk temperature comes down a bit. If you curdle the milk when it's not super hot, the resulting achena will be softer. Now, use a strainer or cotton cloth to drain the remaining water and collect the achena from it. After then, add some cold water to remove remaining vinegar. After this, I squeezed out the remaining water completely from the achena. Make sure that it's not completely dry. The achena should feel soft and moist even after I have squeezed out the water from it. So, don't press it too hard, otherwise it will become dry and resulting rasmalai balls will not be soft. This step is important, so do leave little water in the achena so that it feels soft and moist when you mash it. Now, I start mashing the achena constantly by using my palm till it's smooth and add 1 teaspoon corn flour when it required. Once it's smooth, make small balls out of it. Now, I take pot and add 2 liter of water and add 2 cup or 500 gram of sugar with it and leave it at full flame. Gradually, I drop the balls into the syrup only when it comes to a full boil, and the pot should be at the high flame throughout the duration of 15 to 20 minutes till the balls are cooking. During this time, if you feel the sugar syrup is getting thicker and balls are sticking to the bottom of the pan, then keep adding little water constantly. When the balls are cooked, let them cool down and keep it into ice water for making these balls softer. After 10 minutes, I gradually squeeze the balls carefully and keep it into malai. Now, my Sahi Rasmalai is ready serve. If you like our recipes, please give this video a big thumbs up and don't forget to leave your suggestion and comment in the comment section below. You can also hit the subscribe button to get this types of recipes and don't forget to share this recipes to your loved one. Thanks for watching this video.